Myself and John and Eve would like to welcome to Chris and Jordan as well. Thank you all for coming. I know some of you have quite a great come here. And we thank you for coming. I hope you have a nice day. I've been asked to read this out before my speech. And it says, Chris is a really nice guy. And he will take. I can't read the writing. Before I start, whoever doesn't know me, I'm the FOB.
Right.
That's what you're going to and that's how Jim and Georgina step down. For my speech, I don't want to get too sentimental, because people who know me know I'm quite a sensitive guy. You know? And also, please, bear with, because I will get a bit nervous. Not because of the speeches, because I'm married, I'm not used to speak without really interrupting. Is that okay? I was thinking, you know, Georgina and the wedding.
What's that?
I never thought that I heard those two words in a sentence. You know, so thanks for it. And having this honour of being part of the bride, FOB, or if you know it's FOB, or those part of the bride. I mean, I've got three boys myself, and so I didn't expect to be part of the bride. You know, I'm sure. Managers and beggars and grinders, you know. It was really hard to turn down. Jim was a game of golf, you know. But it's fact, you know. And that's how I came. But to be honest, I am good. And I'm proud of being here. She's a beautiful girl, both inside and out. And maybe you can see that. And I do, I love her unconditionally, you know. But as long as I'm one of those, I do. If I had to choose a daughter, she'd be in my top five. Well, I see top ten. I think Georgie is quite nervous. What I might see here, so I've decided not to mention like the binge drinking, the drugs, the embarrassing two Asbos. So it doesn't use a lot of material. I'm joking, we're doing one actual. Well, what can I say about Georgie? I met her around 18 years ago. And she pretended to be like a shy 11-year-old girl, and you're in that boat, you know. And if my memory serves us right, we hit up straight away. Or she didn't hit up straight away. With the English, we've got the middle line. For the first ever like family day, you know, just getting on with you and living the best behaviour and trying to impress them all, like, you know. And I always remember she went on one of these big lights, big swings that go around. 11 years old. And I was standing watching her. And every time we came around, she spat at us. She actually hit us! I mean,
Mommy.
Over the years, you know, we've had ups and downs. Like all relationships, ups and downs, you know, agree and disagree. Maybe because she doesn't listen. Yeah, didn't listen to any advice from me or her mom and all that. Unless I put it on Facebook. And then it's different. If I put it on Facebook, it's believable. I mean, she's made me laugh over the years. Actually, too many to mention, because if I did, I'd be here all day. And I can see the best man looking nervous. Face up, I follow this guy. Obviously, not school, is this? I'll give you a couple of examples, you know. One is you threaten to sue us for condensation. That's true. And she also told me, quite speaking of that, when she passed the driving test, my dad was going to buy a little gang bang. This is true. This is Laura. And I remember that one, and I asked her, I think she was at school, and I said, hey, do you know where Iceland is, you know? And she looked at like, as I'm shooting, crossbows and shields, I'm in the country. She did, honestly, there was so many. So, when I was writing this speech, I was trying to remember if she ever really annoyed us, you know, over the years, you know. And I always remember one issue that she did. She really annoyed us, you know, because I found porn on my computer. She was telling me she said she was wrong, and there were 4 minutes and that was wrong. It was really annoying. She was telling me how she was she's funny, she's hard working. You have no idea how much work she's put into this. Chris is going to look. Whatever you see here, she's put all her hard work in. She's impulsive, she takes too much on at once. She'll do anything for you if you need help. She's a fat mother, it's a lovely girl, it's a lovely daughter. And that's just pain in the arse at the same time, you know. But I wouldn't change her. And I'm actually extremely proud of her. She did, she looked, I knew she looked gorgeous at the end. And I'm so proud of her. You know, fat girl. I knew you would. And I knew you would. So I'm not going to pick on you too. I think I'm getting a little bit more like her. But Krista. What can I say about Chris? Because his family's here. You're totally upset with him. He seems a nice guy. He's hard working, he loves Georgina, he's good for kids, he's good for dogs, and he'll go his way to help you. Well, that's unless you need like a little box made to go and stop popping your toilets, a little box, you know. It seems to be having a skill set, you know. He's promises for about a year. I'm not sure if he's grown it from scratch. All I want was a little box made. You know? And he does it, he's a nice guy, but I'm not sure if he's, he looks good because all of Georgina's boyfriends we want were right, not yet. The bottom of the army guy, I fight the army guy. He was a nice kid, I agree. Whatever happened to him? So I'm not happy, it looks good because that, but time won't tell anything. But what I will tell you I know about him, that he knows nothing about football. Absolutely nothing about football. Now he plays football on a regular basis, if you know. And
right, you'll end it there.
A few weeks ago, I thought, I better try and bond with this guy. He's going to be so I better try and at least bond with him to see how being nice and all that. So, thought of making a... Now, something to do about that. I'm in this family village where you have a baby store.
And
it's mine. That's like really white. And it's very serious. And some people get our election. But unlike some people, I take it very seriously. And I do it like my wives or my girlfriends. I take it seriously. I don't want to be wiped out on the part of it. I do my own predictions, you know. So the great sacrifice of myself and my reputation. I thought, you know, if they got a chance, you know, it can't be as tough as he looks. I'll do my predictions. You know? And he did them. Impressed him before. It was embarrassing, but I was. I wish I'd asked Ivy or Fern. I would have probably gotten a rare result. So, basically, I won't ask Mickey, and I think this bonding thing is over me. So I won't ask.
Then don't like
them. But what I will say, I'm going to keep it short and sweet, because these guys are getting nervous. These guys are getting very nervous, so they can really know. So, words of advice. You know, marriage. Most people here will tell you it's very hard. It is. Extremely hard work. But the good news is, it does get better. Normally on the second or third marriage, but... So, there's always like a... right end of the tunnel. It's always similar. It does, yeah. It does get better. So, but what I will say, and I'm going to put it to you, is that... Wiser than me, if you can believe me. Certainly once he said, the secret to happiness in marriage is the three H's. Is health, humour, and if you've got health and humour, you'll have the third one, happiness. And that'll get you through most things. Very profound. Getting very emotional, can you believe So, I'll be very kind. There's lots I can say, but I'm not going to. So, all I will say is that on that profound bit of wisdom that I've all given you, and taken it on, you can actually write it down and use it if you want to. Yes, I'd like to raise a toast to Georgina. Georgina. That's it. You felt what you were. Thank you.